something really special, you know, winning the MX of Nations last year with double moto win, and do it here again in the Netherlands in front of my home crowd and even in front of our king. That last moto was amazing, you know, staying on the top step of the box with all the Dutch fans in front. You know what, we had a really, really bad weather conditions. It was raining all day long and it didn't stop any time, so all the fans were still there on the grandstand, so it was amazing.
To have today happen after the year you've had, how does that feel to cap this off with another sweep, two gold plates, likely the number one plate next year when you come here?
Yeah, no, it's amazing, you know. I never could expect that I got two gold plates, and even that second moto, I had an outside gate pick, still managed to get a good start, so that was good.
All right, last question, we'll let you go. I know you're freezing after being in the rain all day. When you guys have so much hype, you know, you're expected to win, the king comes, all these fans are here for you, and you're the predetermined winners before the gates even drop. Is that a lot of pressure for you guys, or did you just block it all out?
For sure it's a lot of pressure, but I didn't feel like that. You know, I'm here to do my job, and in the end we did our job and we won, and that's what we came for. So everyone expects that we win, but of course first need to be done, and now making it happen is very nice.
Yeah, I think the weekend started off pretty good with yesterday with the second place. You know, I got the whole shot, and which was good. I think all the three of us did really good, and we had the pole, so we were pretty happy with that. And then first moto, I made a stupid mistake. You know, I don't know what happened on the start. I messed it up, and then somehow I, instead of shifting to third, I shift to first, and I was like, oh man, I feel such an amateur. And then then I crashed twice, couldn't restart quite quick, so I had to come from the back, finished 17, and wasn't happy with the place, you know, with the result, but the team said, you know, that everybody had some bad models, and the podium was still possible, so I was motivated to do good second moto, but then again I got a bad start and then passed quite some riders. I think I was around 11 already, like after a few corners, and then somebody, I don't know what he did, he went out of the rut, hit me, and I crashed and I was dead last. So pushed hard to be 13 or 12, I don't know which place I finished, but saw every lap that the podium was still possible, so I just kept them going, and it's been a while, you know, since we made the podium, so I think for Team Belgium it was good.
For you personally, it's been an eventful few weeks after getting out of your contract and everything that's going on in this. Where does this put you at, just mentally, after such a big year?
Yeah, mentally, you know, I think I feel still good, you know. When the team kicked me out after China, it was a blow. I think it was a shame actually from their side, but it's, yeah, you know, it is what it is.
So you were let go from the team, you didn't like ask the team, however?
No, they just sent an email after China on Monday evening, not to me, just to my manager, said like there's something happened and we kick you out of the team. He didn't call me anything, so nobody called me. I didn't hear the team manager since GP of Sweden, so it's like 4 weeks. I didn't hear, didn't text me. So I think that's just a stupid thing. And but it is what it is, you know. So I'm really thankful that Yamaha and Wilvel stepped it up for me, and that I could ride their bike with everything on, and really happy with that, you know. And I think I proved for myself and also to other people, if I get a better bike, you know, or a good bike, then I can still run up front, you know. I'm not saying that I can be a world champ, you know, but in between like 5 and 10 it should be possible still.
Didn't disappoint. The weather played into our favor. We had a pretty much a B team, you know. I was selected with Max Anstey and Ben Watson in the beginning, and the day after we were selected, it was game over for that team, because they both got wiped out. And after that, it was the B team. Nathan Watson, come on, Adam Sterry, who's rode fantastic all year. We turned up this weekend, absolutely ready to battle. The weather just poured down today. Yesterday we were all pretty solid. I'd say the track was in decent form. I disagree with what Jeffrey said on the podium interviews with the track was pretty flat. I don't think there could have been anything else they could have done to sort of create some decent racing. It was pretty good. A start was important. There was a lot of roost. Goggles were very important. So these guys were doing a top job. And, you know, to be honest, my first race was incredible. Third place. Kind of salvaged what we had after the first moto. And the second one went pretty good. And the third one was just, you know, let's get all in. You know, let's get really stuck into this. And I had no idea after the finish that we'd manage to make it happen. But, you know, it's the seventh time that I've been on the Motocross of Nations team and the first time I've been on the podium. So absolutely ecstatic.
Yeah, I walked by you. As they told you, and to hear how excited you were, that was cool. Just for me personally, for you, I mean, that's a huge accomplishment after all these tries, especially as you're at this point in your career as well.
Yeah, I think, you know, the two guys that are sat next to me on the podium were absolutely ecstatic as well, but for different reasons. You know, it's their first try and first podium, so you know, that's an incredible accomplishment. For myself, it was just absolutely amazing to see my whole team, my wife, my little boy Angus. He's only 7 months old, and when I seen them behind the podium, I just absolutely broke down in tears. It was it's been a tough year. Something I feel like I should have performed better, and I didn't. So it's been an absolute cherry on the cake to finish the year off strong.
Yeah, great experience overall. I'm glad I was picked. Like I said, blessed to be in this position. Saturday went really good. Went out and won my qualifying race, and you know, Sunday we had the weather against us today, and it was it made everything just that much more treacherous. Of course, first lap. If anything's gonna happen, it's gonna happen first lap, and that's pretty much what happened. Me and Jason actually came together. I didn't know it was Jason until after my second race. And then I watched the video and I realized Jason hit me. So I was like, well, that's very unfortunate. So yeah, just unlucky there. And it sucks it was first lap, but yeah, there's not much more to say. It's just kind of tough pill to swallow that it happened first lap and we both went down and kind of just put ourselves, you know, behind the eight ball right away. So after that, I was having problems with my hand, and I got some injections before the second moto, taped it up a little bit, but it was honestly hard to even pull in the clutch, so kind of just rode around out there in pain, but figured I'd, you know, go out and ride while I was here, so now we're going to head back tomorrow, and everything's over with.
Okay, when I saw you come around on those first few laps in Moto 1, and the clutch lever just jumping up and down, and the front brake can beat you, how do you do that in the sand when you have no controls pretty much? Luckily,
yeah.
Like you get to like have the momentum to feel by how heavy the sand is.
Yeah, so pretty much I ended up going down again, and I realized I couldn't, like, you know, get going. So I actually had to like rev it up really high and bump it into first, and like, because I had no clutch or like anything to do with that, so had to really focus on not crashing, and it was kind of dumb. Like, I just had to take my time everywhere because I couldn't save myself with the clutch if I messed up in a turn. Kind of just had to roll around the track, you know, pretty smooth, but while eating roost with no vision. So pretty much a nightmare of a day, but overall thankful for the experience. A lot of positives that come away from this, even though we're going home and, you know, a little hurt and whatever happened today, but nothing we can't bounce back from, and just, you know, you live and you learn, so it's a tough day, but, you know, I'm not going to get down on myself about it. We're all in good spirit, and I think we're proud of ourselves. We made a big step in the right direction for Team USA, I think, just being united and, you know, even taking the time to come over here early and, you know, get prepared as well as we could have. I felt we were prepared as well as, like, pretty much as good as we could have coming into this race, and proud of all that and proud of all the sacrifice that, you know, all Team USA made for us. And overall, good experience, happy with how it went, even though it, you know, went shitty today, but we'll learn from it.
Obviously, you know, the weekend started, we did practice yesterday, and the qualifying race didn't go too bad. I was able to get six, but still not fully comfortable, and then was really looking forward to today, and We went out there for the first moto, and obviously the conditions were brutal today. Probably some of the gnarliest stuff I've ridden. But went out for the first moto, and was, I think, around maybe like 10th, 11th, you know, because I gave Justin the better gate, and I was on the outside. But came in, and, you know, just first lap carnage, got me and Justin, just tried to work my way forward. And just tried my best. Had to throw the goggles and had a little bit of a tip over. I think I got up to like maybe 12th or 11th at one point. But yeah, it's kind of a bummer. But at the same time, showed up for the second moto and was up there. I think I was up to 6th behind Horbeck for a little bit. And when I got up to him, I feel like I was pretty close. And ended up falling over and... I think I would have got passed by Hurlings anyway. He was on a mission, and Prado got me. So, yeah, ended up 8th. But all in all, put my heart into it, and then that's really all we can do.
I mean, these have been a huge 3 weeks. I think public opinion of you has been huge. You and the boys have had a great time.
Like, yeah.
Everything has been good. So, results aside, this was a successful trip.
Yeah. Later. Are you out of here? Yeah, okay. Yeah. Like I said, I tell Zach and I tell Justin, no matter the result, we tried our best. The last 3 weeks, we have had a hell of a time traveling Europe, learning sand, and you know, I want to thank those guys because we stepped into the deep end, you know, and it was it was conditions that we knew that we had. Didn't have the upper hand, you know, and I think that all in all, we tried our butts off and we were as much prepared as we could be. But you know, you look back on it, you know, 10 years from now, or even, you know, next year, we had a hell of a time, and we enjoyed it, and these are memories that'll, you know, last forever, win or lose. You'll probably laugh about the shitty days when it's over, you know. So all in all, I'm just gonna do what we do best, and I'm going to race on the weekend, so I'll see you next weekend at Straight Rhythm.
As a whole, it was okay. Today, I struggled a little bit in the second race. First moto was okay. I was 5th, and the second moto, I just was kind of mid-pack on the start and didn't make a lot of progress when I needed to when everyone was close, and had to stop for goggles, just one of those deals. It was kind of worst-case scenario from the very first lap of the very first moto when Jason and Justin came together. So, you know, we did everything we could do coming into the race. We put in a lot of effort and a lot of testing and training, but it doesn't always go that way whenever, you know, when you expect it to. So it is what it is. I mean, we'll keep fighting.
Considering all that went into this, do you still feel accomplished? I mean, obviously you have to.
Yeah, of course. We can rest easy knowing that we put everything we could into it, and we were here when, you know, when we needed to be, and did all the necessary things to be good. It just didn't go our way today. It is very one-off. Such a strange sand, such a strange soil. It's just one of those deals where, yeah, it's something you ride once in a lifetime, probably for us, you know. But, yeah, we'll just keep plugging away. These colors don't run.
I have this opinion that you should be on the team every year. Kind of like OTA is.
Yeah.
You want to be here. You lead the charge. Is that something you would be interested in? Would you take this opportunity every time, even though it is such a hassle to come here and such a burden on yourself just emotionally?
Yeah, I mean, I would sign up again in the morning, even if it was meant 3 weeks here again or whatever. I think it's just what I feel led to do, honestly. I mean, I love this race. I love the Team USA. I love my country. And I mean, I really desperately want to win one of these before my career is over, so hopefully I have some more chances.
Do